This time we will talk about cornering. That was some true cornering in there, and probably drifting before drifting become popular. And that's, of course, one way to look at cornering. Then we probably need to separate racing and making profitable transports from each other, because if we think of the similarities and differences in between truck racing and transporting goods for earning money with it, I guess we're a little bit optimizing different things. There are similarities in truck racing and in truck driving, driving on roads. I guess you want to get through events in relatively good pace. You want to have high average speed, but in truck racing, we aim for the best time, and we compromise fuel economy. You can also hear wheels squeaking. You can see that the truck is being pushed to right direction with the rear a little bit skidding, and the trucks are oversteering because of the loss of traction in the rear and so on. And in racing, that doesn't really matter, because all we want to do is to have the fastest time and beat the others, and we don't need to worry about the cost of fuel or how much tires we are wearing out, or if the brake linings or brake pads in modern trucks will wear out really fast. We don't really need to worry about that. So we take that cost and we try to get through the track as fast as possible and overtake as many of our competing trucks as possible. But then if we talk about driving a truck like this, Volvo FH, could be any other truck, we're on the road, we try to haul goods or other types of materials into destination, be on time, but make it profitable business. And to make it profitable business, you need to take care of your costs. If your costs are higher than what you can afford, your transport company is making loss. If what you gain from transport mission and what you can invoice is more than what your costs are, then you're earning money and truck makes profit. So from that perspective, we would want to minimize all the tire and parts wear and the fuel consumption and still make it in time, have high average speed and make your load to the destination with minimum costs and still being in time. So we are optimizing good time, but not at any cost. We want to keep the fuel and tire wear and parts wear under control. So what we do is we try to be smooth. We put a cup of coffee to your dashboard and then we start driving and you don't spill the coffee. And the idea of that is that then we minimize all the lateral accelerations of the truck, and that will cut out tire wear. If you start driving really fast, then of course you will see wear in tire. But we have also here all these joints that will take quite heavy forces. If you do a lot of braking in the corners, of course you will experience added brake pad and disc, or in case of drum brakes, brake lining wear. But then these components, if you have maximum front axle load and you go in the corners really fast, that will take its toll. So it's not only fuel, brakes, it's also added wear of components, and you start feeling that earlier as you drive with the truck with a little bit loose steering when these joints wear out here, and then the truck will not be as stable to stay on course when you drive at high speed. So that's also a good thing to take good care of the truck you're driving. And most of all, we will see fuel saving, because whenever the truck is skidding sideways, part of the momentum of the truck gets converted into heat and tire wear. And that's an energy loss, and that's added fuel consumption. So we don't want to do that. So the question is how to gain as high average speed as possible without having the tire wear. And keeping the coffee in the cup gives you a good visual tool to understand how you should be doing it. Practical tips how to keep the coffee in the cup. First of all, when you enter a corner, and this is very much similar with race car driving or race truck driving and fuel economical driving. It doesn't matter if you get fast into the corner if you cannot get out of it fast. So what we try to do is that we have a good controlled braking before the corner. We try to be at walking pace when we get to the corner. And then hopefully with good anticipation, we can see if there's others coming and how to react to that. And then we can get through the corner without spilling the coffee, being really smooth. By this strategy, you often gain average speed compared against the driver who comes really fast to the corner, has to do a full stop and has to start from the beginning getting going again. We slow down well ahead of time. We come in with walking pace. We observe others in the traffic and then we do smooth and wide turn through the event. And as we do as wide turn as possible, the axles of the trailers will not hold us back. If you do really tight cornering, then the trailer axles and all the axles of the combination will resist your turning, and that's fuel going to waste. So we want to do as wide turn as the corner allows us to do. And then we wait until we see in the mirror that all the trailer, or in case of long combinations, all the trailers are lined up with the truck. And once the whole combination is in straight line, then we start accelerating. Because if you start accelerating when the trailer is still in an angle towards the truck, you're sort of pulling and twisting the axles, and that's energy lost. So we want to line them up. And once they are lined up, then we start smoothly accelerating. So we come in with relatively low pace. We observe when we have a low speed. We have time to take decisions. Then we do as wide turn as possible to prevent any excess restricting forces from the bent axles. And once you see in the mirror that now the whole combination is lined up, then we start accelerating. And this will give you really good average speed in normal traffic environment. And the ones who try to come like they stole it, they often do a full stop and start again with the low gears, and then you actually lose time and fuel. So that's how we will attack these situations. And the good thing with this slow approach is when the roads get slippery again, might get icy in Northern Europe eventually, when you come in at nice and slow pace, then you also have lower risk of actually running out of your course, and then you get through these events and corners in a safe manner without losing the control of the vehicle or even ending up off the road. So we want to take good care of the truck, its axle components, tires. We want to keep the fuel consumption low, and we want to take good care of the cargo, and therefore we try to keep the coffee in the cup when we do these corners. We don't want to be spilling the coffee. Thank you for watching. See you next time.